kids, it's favorites time again. I'm really excited about this month because I found some really amazing products. A lot of these are just awesome and I'm so excited that I found them. Not only that, but I think all but one of these products are drugstore products. Of course, first things first, I did this last year, you guys loved it. I'm gonna do it this year because I actually kind of love it too. So we're going to do the hated it segment before I get into the things that I liked. I was really disappointed with this because I thought that I was gonna really like it a lot, but I decided to check out Nicki Minaj's collection of nail polishes for OPI, and I picked up the color Pink Friday, and this is what it looks like. It's just kind of like a baby pink, and I thought that I was really gonna like it. So like that night when I got home, I was so excited and I put it on my toenails and I kind of hated it. And I'm really surprised because I love Nicki Minaj pink. It just something about the formula I didn't like so much. I felt like it was very streaky and chalky. The color is nice, but the formula just, I don't know, there were like a lot of streaks on my toenails. Like it just didn't look right. And I almost felt like I needed a base coat first. And I don't know, I'm impatient. So if it requires a lot of steps, I just kind of forget about it because I just don't want to do it. Yeah, I'm pretty disappointed with it. I was expecting it to be a lot better. I know that there are a lot of people who do like this nail polish and maybe you're one of them. For me personally, I really didn't like it at all. And I'm actually going to return this. The only reason why I haven't yet is because I wanted to do this video first, but I really, really hated it. Sorry, Nicki, because I do love Nicki Minaj, but I really hated this color. Well, I find myself in quite the situation right now because I want to throw it as I normally do, but this is glass, so I'm thinking it's probably not a good idea. This might be the first time in history that I don't throw the product that I hated. I'm really sad and disappointed right now. I can get through this. I can do it just by setting down the product that I don't. No, I can't. I can't. I have to throw something. This has nothing to do with the nail polish, but hated it. Oh, I feel so much better. Whew. I was just gonna be off for the rest of the video if I didn't get to throw something, okay? And I know you guys would have too, because it's just not right. I need to be throwing things. Okay. Now let's get into the products that I really, really liked. On the flip side of the Nicki Minaj nail polish collection, I did find one color that I really, really loved. So as much as I hated the Pink Friday color, I love this one just that much. This one is called Metallic for Life, and it's this black color with these silver chunks in it of glitter. And what I really, really love about this, and what makes this different from any nail polish of this type that I've used before, is that the glitter pieces are assorted. So there's big glitter pieces and little glitter pieces, and there's round ones and square ones and teeny ones and short ones and whatever. And so it just creates this really, like, it's almost like a mosaic of glitter with a black backdrop. It's very poetic. Mm-hmm. It sparkles in a bottle. What's there not to like? So these are my favorite things that I found for the entire month, because you guys know I kind of like to mention what my absolute favorite thing of the month was, and it was the Revlon lip butters, and I have four of them. I wasn't even planning on picking these up. Just, I don't know, you know, the commercial, it just kind of looked like it was something that wasn't for me. You guys know I like rich colors, and I just figured that it was more of like a lip treatment with just a little bit of tint, and these are actually really great, and they're very pigmented considering that it's a lip treatment. So I picked up four of them because they were buy one, get one free. This one's my favorite. This color is called Lollipop, and it's seriously like extremely pigmented considering what it is. Here, let me just show you guys real quick. That's really pigmented for a lip butter. It really is. And this color, I get tons of compliments on this color. Let me actually just show you guys the swatches for all four of these real quick. So as you can see, those are very pigmented, and what I really love about these is that they are so moisturizing. It's like coating your lips with silk. I have never used a lip product that I love more than this. And like, I feel like it's even improved the condition of my lips. Like, I feel like my lips feel softer and smoother and silkier even when I'm not wearing the lip butter, just because it's almost like I have a treatment on all day. I've been using these every single day since I got them like 3 weeks ago. So every day I'm using one of them, and I don't know how I ever lived without them. This is one of the favorite products I've found in a really long time. And I've heard some people kind of complain that they don't really love the packaging. I personally really like it. I don't know, like, let me just show you guys. It looks kind of textured. It kind of reminds me of like the old school lipsticks that you would get at the dollar store. So yeah, it does look cheap, I guess I'll say, but I like it because it's so vintage, and it kind of reminds me of, I remember when I was little, my aunt would get those dollar store lipsticks. And they had, you know, they all had the textured casing like this. I remember, like, we'd be sitting in church or whatever, and, like, while everybody was, you know, praying and singing and hymning and hominin' and doing whatever, I would be sitting there, like, going through my aunt's purse, pulling out all of her lipsticks and playing with them. So I really love the packaging. I don't care if it looks like it got out at the dollar store, because it makes me feel like a little girl again playing with my aunt's lipstick. I bet not one of you is surprised that I didn't pay attention in church, okay? Moving right along. I talked about these in my last haul video, I think, but they made it to my favorites because I love using them so much. It's the Maybelline Dream Bouncy Blush. And I remember going, like, on and on about how strange these feel, but I really do like them a lot. I still can't get over how bouncy they are. It's really strange when I'm using them. Like, I have to kind of, like, keep myself on task because I keep playing with them. That's what she said. But one issue that I usually have with the creamier blushes is when they're overly pigmented, they're really hard to blend. And I feel like these are just sheer enough that I can blend them easily into my cheeks and not have to worry about, like, streaked blush or anything like that. So I really like these. If you're really into blush and you don't feel like spending, like, $20 or $25 on NARS, then I would say that the Maybelline blush would be your next best bet. So this next product I also talked about in my last haul video, and it made it to my favorites because it's so freaking sparkly. How could it not? But it's the Revlon Diamond Lust eyeshadow, and it's this color specifically, Neptune Star, because I've been playing with this one a lot, coming up with a couple looks that I have coming up, and oh my god, I am so in love with this color, you guys. The quality, the color, the pigmentation of this is, to me, comparable to what you would get from, like, Makeup Forever or something like that. I am absolutely impressed with this eyeshadow. Let me swatch it for you guys. But I picked up a couple of colors, but this one's my favorite, so that's why this one made it to favorites. But this one looks absolutely stunning. You definitely need a base with it, but it just, look at the sparkle there and the uniqueness of this color. It's just, it's like midnight blue, but then it's got, like, iridescent sparkles in it, and it's just so gorgeous. It kind of reminds me of, like, I don't know, when you go to the beach at night and then you see the sky and it's like the color, it's kind of like bouncing off the water or whatever, and it's like this beautiful, like, midnight kind of blue color, and then the stars are twinkling. That's kind of what this looks like. So I think they really, like, named it properly when they named it Neptune Star. So the next thing I'm going to talk about is the Revlon Photo Ready Airbrush Foundation. I picked this up about 3 weeks ago, and so far I really like it. Compared to the other Photo Ready foundation, I would say it's pretty comparable, just a little bit lighter. So that's why I like this, because I don't like really heavy foundations. So I find the Photo Ready to be a little bit too heavy for every day for me. That's something that I would use, like, for a photo shoot or for filming or something like that. But this one, it's kind of a just a little bit toned down version of that, which is why I really like it. It's basically like whipped cream in a can or easy cheese or whatever, but it just comes out, like, in a foam. And then, as you can see, let me show you, it's, like, kind of bubbling right there. And then you just kind of, like, pat it down and it turns into foundation. But I think because of the air in it, it spreads a lot more evenly and lighter, and that's why I really like it. And it's been about 3 weeks and I haven't broken out or anything like that, so I think that this is a pretty, this is a pretty good foundation for people with sensitive skin, because my skin is very sensitive to new foundations for some reason. So I break out really easily, and this one hasn't caused me to break out at all. The only complaint I would have with this is that it's maybe not quite as long lasting as the original Photo Ready, but I just reapply a little bit if I need to, or just put some setting powder on it and I'm fine. But all in all, I really like this, and this is, well, this is actually the foundation that I'm wearing for every day. It's actually the foundation I'm wearing right now. I think it was like $13, which for drugstore, that's about right. So we'll see how long this lasts me, but so far I've been using this every day and I still have a good amount of product left. So I think this is a really good buy. If you're looking for a new drugstore foundation, then this is probably the one to try. I also tried the Maybelline, their new, I forget what that one's called. I think it's like Dream Mousse Air or something, and that one actually doesn't feel like I'm wearing foundation at all. I don't know, I didn't really like that one. So if you're gonna go for one of the new Air foundations, I think Revlon is probably the better bet. So this next thing was also for my haul video. See, this is why I don't really do haul videos, because a lot of the things end up overlapping and they end up in my favorites videos. But this was Stila's new Diamond Lust, or not Diamond Lust, what is this called? Stila Jewel eyeshadow. I be buying too many damn sparkles and I forget what it's all called. Sparkly Exhibit A and Sparkly sparkly exhibit B is what I need to start calling stuff. This is the color opal, and I really love this. I've been wearing this pretty much every day. I know people don't really wear sparkles every day, but I wear sparkles every day because that's just kind of how I am. I've been wearing this color on my lid pretty much every day, and I've been getting tons of compliments on it from coworkers and, you know, the people at Starbucks, because that's pretty much the only two places I ever go these days. A lot of people are just like, wow, it's so pretty because it's like sparkly, but it's not too sparkly. There's like glitter pieces, but they're not too obvious. So it's, I would call it like office sparkly, kind of, which is why I really like this. It was $20, so that's a little bit pricey for an eyeshadow, but I have yet to find a comparable one that's cheaper. So until then, I'll be spending $20 on this one. This is actually gonna be my next tutorial, is the everyday look that I've been doing, because I've been actually just wearing this on my lids and then wearing one of the lip butters, and it's pretty much been my everyday look, and I'm getting compliments left and right. So I will do a tutorial for you guys, because I figure if that many other people like it, you guys are probably gonna like it too. So the last thing I'm gonna talk to you guys about is the Maybelline Color Tattoo eyeshadow, and I've been hearing a lot about this on YouTube. I think I picked this up on the same day that I got the lip butter, so I've been playing with this a lot and I really like it a lot. Normally I hate cream eyeshadows because I have a very oily crease, so they crease really easily on me, and this is probably the first cream shadow that hasn't done that. So I picked up two colors. This is the one that I've been wearing the most. This one is called Tenacious Teal. Look at how pretty that is. Let me swatch it for you guys. It's actually the color that I'm wearing right now. I'm not sure how well you guys can see that, but I absolutely love this color. It looks really great against brown eyes. It really pops. Look at how highly pigmented that is. This is insane. For a drugstore eyeshadow that's under $10, to be this pigmented is crazy, okay? So if you're looking for a drugstore shadow that's really highly pigmented, then I highly suggest getting the Color Tattoo eyeshadows, because look at how pigmented this is. So let me show you the other color I got. I don't know what the heck I did with it. So I guess finding it would help me show it to you, wouldn't it? It was hiding from me. So the other color I got is called... it's called Edgy Emerald, and that's what it looks like. It's kind of, to me, it's like a sea green. This doesn't look very emerald to me. To me, emerald is more like a darker green, and this is more like a sea green. Either way, it is beautiful. That's what this one looks like. Also really gorgeous. I'm very impressed with these. My hand looks like a kindergartner just took markers and drew all over me, is what my hand looks like right now. So if you do kind of stay away from cream shadows because they crease on you, just know that if you're wearing a base, this is probably gonna work fantastic, and you're gonna get all this lovely pigmentation. I'm like Vanna White for makeup. A lot tanner too. And not as blonde. Well, because I'm not blonde at all. So those are my favorite products for the month of January. Let me know if you guys have tried any of these products out. If you like them, don't like them, what you guys think, go ahead and let me know down below in the comments. I love to start like little conversations on there, especially you guys start talking amongst yourselves. And it's like watching my children, you know, talk at the dinner table together. It makes me so happy. It really, really does. What is coming up next? The next tutorial is probably the everyday look that I've been doing. So I think I'm probably gonna do that one this weekend. We'll see. So otherwise, thank you guys so much for stopping by to hang out with me, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.